So let's start and greetings to all of you and welcome to Hyperledger Global Forum. I am Kartika Murthy, a software engineer working with Intel for the past 9 years. And I have my colleague Manjunath, and he's also worked for the past year. We have been contributing towards applying blockchain on enterprises for the last 3 years. So today we are here to present Hyperledger Evlon. And Hyperledger Evlon was solely developed by Intel, and Intel was a primary maintainer of Evlon. But in the recent quarter, the leading global company Wipro has been made as the maintainer of Evlon. So Manjunath will take over to the rest of the slides. Over to you, Manjunath.
Thank you, Kartika. Can you? Yes. Okay. Okay. Let's look at what is Hyperledger Evlon. I guess if you are a newcomer or newbie to Evlon, let's just see what is Evlon and how it started. So initially, right? I mean, all the blockchain frameworks, when they execute computationally intensive transactions or workloads, participants in the node or blockchain, they have to process the transaction. This was leading to a lot of resource crunch, and it was impacting on the performance a lot. And also there was a privacy concern issues when there are multiple parties participating in the consortium. So to address this main issue, Enterprise Ethereum Alliance initially started to developing a spec to solve these issues. It was only the Ethereum was in mind, and then later the spec got evolved and it was made generic so that even the solution can be adopted to even non-ledger solutions as well. So that is how Hyperledger Evlon got started, and it's a ledger independent implementation of the trusted compute spec developed by Enterprise Ethereum Alliance. And currently in Evlon, we have integrated Hyperledger Fabric and Hyperledger.
Hello, I think this is breaking. So let me continue on the So the main goal of Evlon would be the data security while performing computation on data. So Evlon offloads the transaction to a centralized entity called Trusted Compute. So we enable improved throughput and scalability. And I would also like to mention that Evlon provides attested oracles, tested reports of the data generated outside of blockchain. So this way we trust that the trust is developed between known clients and our users. So the sponsors, talking about the sponsors, we have Intel, IBM, Microsoft, Alibaba, Baidu, and we have already published the open source, and I've told before that Wipro is the current maintainers of the app. So going to the next slide. So let us talk about a small business case, which is using Evlon for providing the data security. So now consider a small scale business, so which is interested in a medical insurance coverage for its employee and want to protect the confidential health data of the employees involved. And an insurance company can provide a required quote, but it depends upon the hospitals for the user data, which in turn is an encrypted as per hospital policy. So the hospital, insurance company, and a small scale business cannot be trusted each other with the data. So this is where Hyperledger Evlon based at Hero is providing a secure channel for a small scale business to meet the requirement in an untrusted environment. Yeah, Manju, you want to talk about the use case? I mean, I've just given an overview about the use case now. Manju? Okay, so the hospital encrypts the data. So initially the hospital encrypts the data, which can be decrypted only inside an exchange enclave. So such a encrypted data is only passed to the insurance company on request and in agreement with the enterprises. So if you see in this way, the data, employees data, health data, which you consider to be very confidential, it still stays confidential and because it can be decrypted only within an enclave. And such data is passed to the insurance company. And the insurance company also tries to apply its algorithm over it, but all this execution happens within another Intel SGX enclave. So what we see is, as an outsider, the data is never disclosed, because the data is always encrypted for an outsider, and the insurance company can also give a quote about the health details or anything as per the enterprise has asked. So this way we find that the hospital, insurance company and the business are trusting each other. A trust-based execution is established. So going forward to the next slide. So this is a demo of the hard case evaluation. It is something like the insurance company itself. And Manju, you're online now. Can you hear?
Yes, I can hear you.
You can continue with this demo.
Sure. Okay, let us look at the business use case of Avalon here. As you can see, there are three entities. One is a business, it could be a corporate company, and insurance company, and the hospital.
I think I have covered that. Maybe we have to talk about the demo of the hard risk evaluation.
Okay, sure. Okay, can you move to that particular slide?
Yeah, I'm already pointing to that.
Okay, I'm seeing the use case demo. Just go back and come back again.
Yeah, I did.
Okay,
it is. You can see the pointer. So which slide are you seeing? Is it the demo slide or the use case slide?
Okay, no issues. I can talk about it. 1 second. Yes. Okay. So as Kartika was giving the introduction about the business use case, this demo is a heart disease evaluation example that is provided as a reference implementation in the Avalon code. And what you see in the left-hand corner is it's a UI client at the client side, where you can input all your employee health data, like your age, your blood sugar, it could be cholesterol. All those parameters could be entered in the UI client. And when you submit, all the data, all the patient's data is encrypted, and it will be sent to the Avalon framework. And only in the Avalon place where you deploy the Avalon, the trusted execution environment implemented using Intel SGX, it will be able to decrypt the result, and the algorithm, which will basically, apply some logic on these parameters, and it can come up with the evaluation. What is the probability of getting a heart disease from this patient data? At the top right corner, you can also see that in the response, all the data is also again encrypted, and the client will have the corresponding encryption key. It can use the encryption key, and it could decrypt the result. And it can, at the end, it can view the result. You can see you have 45% risk of heart disease. So this demonstrates the end-to-end confidentiality from the moment the client submits request till it gets the response. The whole cycle, the request and response are encrypted, and it is only authorized entities can view the results. Okay. And can you move to the next slide, please? Okay. So coming up is what are the latest developments that we have done? So from the past few quarters, what we have done is we have segregated the key management responsibility and the work order processing logic into a two separate processes. We call it as a key management enclave and the work order processing enclave. And this will enable us to enable us to achieve a greater scalability, so that we have we can intake multiple requests at a time. And all this will be processed by a set of work order processing enclaves. And we are also coming up with key management enclave replication technologies. It's in the pipeline. And recently we have integrated the Graphene library OS to the Avalon. What Graphene does is, in the traditional Avalon, it only supports C++ based workloads to be integrated with the TEE. But what if we want to run the existing already developed existing applications inside the trusted execution environment? And Graphene provides that support, and we have provided the integration of Graphene, and also we have provided a support for receipt handling in the direct mode. And till now we used to support only Docker based deployments, and right now we are supporting Kubernetes based deployment is also available. And also we have a support for Nginx based load balancer, for basically handling multiple requests coming in from the different clients. It will be, correspondingly it will be redirected to different listeners, and correspondingly it gets processed. So these are the some of the key highlights of recent developments that we have done. And moving on. Is it more? Okay, so we can see some of the references to Avalon here. Basically, the open source repository is available in the GitHub, and all the contributions to open source is accessible. Take a look at the source code, and if you'd like to contribute, we welcome you to contribute. And we can also see the project proposal here, and we have a good number of blogs. And the in the previous slide, I showed the evaluation demo, a screenshot, and this is the YouTube video which will demonstrate demonstration of heart disease evaluation. And we have a wiki for Avalon as well, and we conduct monthly once a developer forum. Please feel free to join. And that brings us to the end of the project demo.
So if you have any questions, please let us know. We will answer you right here online.
Also, you could contact us if you have questions. Maybe we can, take those questions offline as well. And so currently, Avalon implements a trusted execution environment using Intel SGX hardware technology. There are other alternatives to it. One is the same spec can be implemented using AMD-based TrustZone, or you can completely use a software-based trusted execution environment like Zero Knowledge Proof or multi-party compute. The spec is open for all the flexibility.
Thank you
everyone for joining the session. It was a pleasure having this pleasure presenting the session at Hypolager Global Forum. Thank you.
Bye.